Fire Marshal gonna come in here. Hey, all the ladies been sending this stuff.
I'm happy and nervous at the same time.
Hey, everybody catching bullet holes. Hey. Hey, but this is Unrestricted Radio, and Wednesdays are
Unrestricted.
And this is a special edition of Unrestricted Radio. Hold on, before we get into anything, we got to send a special birthday shout out to the first lady of the show, Miss Mo. Momo.
Happy birthday, Mo.
Happy birthday, Mo. And I'm mad you ain't tell us where y'all was at, because you was local and you knew we was going to crash it and we didn't have no money to put in, so we was going to show up late, broke, and eat up everything and party hard.
But she already knew that by the time that she posts all her pictures that she normally do, then we're going to know where she was at.
Exactly. So
that's enough about Mo. It's about us guys right now.
Absolutely. Sorry, Mo. Happy birthday. We love you, but we gotta go to this fella show, man. It's, man, it probably look different up here. We got some people we gotta introduce. First, right here, my main man from Boys to Bow Ties, my man BJ.
What's up, man?
Clap it up for my man BJ in the building. This guy grew up with him in the neighborhood, so I know he's official. As a grown man, he's official. So we're going to get nothing but great answers and great responses from this intelligent brother right here.
Man, thank you, sir. Now I'm going to do to my man. You know what I'm saying? My man's in there.
Your man's in there. You know what I'm saying? Your man's in there.
Big Zoe, you know, I know him from basketball. Y'all know him from parties. And y'all know him from everything else.
Oh, that's Big Zoe that be on all the flies that be throwing them good parties and stuff. Okay. You know? Okay.
So
okay.
Now that he on the show, so maybe he can slide his head a couple of
times. You know what I'm saying? I make sure everybody taking care of before I leave.
Yeah. Good man. Good
I appreciate man. That. I appreciate that. So we also got some other people in the building. Over here, we got my man Gino from Boys to Bow Ties. Clap it up for him too.
What's up, Gino?
We also got. Hey, hold up. We ain't clapping up for Zoe. We got clapping up for Zoe too. Yeah, we celebrating the minute day. Damn that. And next to him, we got TCB Tony, yes. The original TCB Tony.
What's up, Tony?
The original TCB Tony.
We chilling up here in the shop. Unrestricted.
This the Unrestricted Barbershop. Ain't nobody gonna get a shape up, but they might feel like they get cut. What are you like? Damn, like shit, come good. Hey, this is a special show right here.
I want to listen to Baby Great, man.
Hey. So hold up. First of all, let's explain to people who might not have saw the flyer and saw exactly what we're doing. This is the Barbershop Live Cook.
Great.
They're already
going
on fire.
Already.
Already.
Hey, look.
Let's just jump in.
I'm doing something new. Yeah, I'm
just jump in. Just jump in. Don't even scream.
Unrestricted Radio Show. Unrestricted Radio Show.
Hello?
Who's this? Who's this?
Oh, shit. See, that's why I can't hear that.
It sounds like you got water in that phone.
No, man, what you do? Go put it in some rice or something, man. Come on, man. What you know about it? Come on.
Hey,
man, I get it.
Say what?
I said, why they getting it together? Go ahead and throw a question out there.
You
sure?
Nobody or holding no type of organization. It's like, man, if it's because of no money involved, I don't know.
All Look, this, I'm going to repeat the question for the people that didn't hear, right? He said his question, well, this wasn't about a relationship. This is about what's going on right now in the nation, right?
When he spoke on,
he said, like, you look at all these black men that are coming out. A lot of black churches ain't coming out speaking out, helping out in these communities with all this stuff that's going on with these marches and stuff like that. He said he feel like, I guess, because these churches are not getting money or not getting ties at all for jumping out here helping these black governments.
Yeah.
You try, basically want to know, like, how do we feel about that situation, about the black churches not being out there helping out?
That's tough. Go ahead.
I really can't speak on that because, I mean, I know church is a business, but a lot of this stuff started at home, man. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That's all of what you teach your children. It's all the type of vibe you have your children around, you know? Of course, we need our black churches to step in and intervene. We need everybody to intervene. This is not a situation where, you know, we point the fingers. You know what I'm saying? Point the fingers right now is the worst thing we can do because nobody's to blame right now. Right now, we need solutions. We don't need the problem. We know what the problem is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The problem is out there. We know what the problem is. We can identify the problem all across this nation. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But we need everybody to step in and say, hey, I want to do my part. Hey, I want to be the solution. That's what we need. We need solutions. We don't need problems.
And
But let's be fair to the black churches. We can't account for all churches. You know what I'm saying? So we don't know if it's a black church in California doing something or not. So let's not say, you know,
churches do a lot.
Certain ones.
Churches don't ratify. And I think people get that confused. Me and Junior had that debate a lot. You know, Junior, my brother, he just called in. Mm-hmm. He beefed sometimes. I'm not going to name drop churches. Churches that I deal with do a lot in the community. But you know what they won't do? Poke their chest out and say, hey, I did it.
Yeah. And that's how
I feel. Yeah, some churches
do. Some do. But the ones that we know see won't never get the credit. Right. Because they got poked their chest out.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
So that's a tough question.
Y'all fellas got anything?
On the thing with you said, if all black men give 30 minutes, you have to change the way they think first. Because 30 minutes of this man's time might ruin a child's life. You gotta start with teaching people how to be the solution. It's on. You hear me?
Keep going.
So, you know, we have to teach them how to be the solution. We just all can't just jump out there and say, okay, I'm gonna take this kid under my wing. But the path you're going is the wrong way. You know, so I can't say that if all black men give 30 minutes is not the solution, because that's a start. Like, if you take 30 minutes with your own,
oh man,
right.
45 minutes with your own, you know, that's the solution.
Yeah, Gino, right, jump into something else. That's another topic, Gino.
You know, that's the solution in its own. You know, I just don't see it as being a one answer type of question. This is not a one answer type of question. So there's multiple things we can do, but the problem is that we all just sit around and talk about it. It sound good. That's perfect way to good. Yeah, everybody thought solutions and it sound good. Nobody want to put the work behind those solutions.
Yes, indeed. So that was the first phone call. Let's see what we have in this bag of tricks here.
Oh boy, let's see. I'm gonna start it off easy, y'all fellas. Pause.
Bing.
Let's see. Hold on, where my cars at? I got some cars too.
I know it's a lot. It's a lot of phone. I mean, a lot of questions in there.
You gonna get hot after 9 o'clock or whatever? Let's see.
Let's get it.
I don't know, fellas.
I'm telling you, I got like.
He sees something personal in it. He's like, nah, this probably about me. I'm going to put this joint back. I'm going to put this joint back.
Well, I need to add those in.
He left those out. Those in. We about to shake you down.
Let's do something. I mean, it is important, but are men concerned about credit scores?
Jesus.
Grown men, yes. Okay. I mean, you know, if you're a young nigga and you're probably not worried about your credit score at the time, because I wasn't worried about my credit score. I probably could have had like an 800 credit score if I put my money in the right place when I was young instead of buying dumb stuff like big jewelry and like crazy stuff. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I was walking around with them hair bones on.
Oh, no. I'm talking about, like, I mean, there was a time, actually, and I'm ashamed to say this, that I walked around with like 10 grand worth of jewelry. And that was kind of, that's stupid. You know what I'm saying? Like, at the point where I was then, you know what I'm saying? Like, maybe years down the line and I had it like that, yes, but no, I was wearing my money.
All right, well, I'm going to say it like this. Honestly, coming up where I came up from, like, credit was never taught to me.
Never.
You know, it was never even brought to my attention. So I got a credit card. My first credit card was $500.
After
my first three paying shit.
You was at the bar. He was like, you want a hat, cuz? Because you my man. That's why, cuz. Swipe that joint, bro.
My friends, all that. See, but I was never taught about credit. You know what I mean? Credit was never brought to me in my school. It was never taught to me in my home.
Never.
You know what I mean? Like, we had some of the people in our kids in our family had bills in their name.
Everything.
You know what I mean? So, like, we wasn't taught that. You know what I'm saying? So now when you become a grown man and you evolve and you get a job, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You trying to impress them. You want to get your nice car. You go to that dealership and you thinking you want to go ahead and, you know, I got $5,000. Your interest rate
23%. Bang! That's when they crack you in the head right there.
Hey, let me pick up this call real quick. This is Junior calling back. Junior.
JR.
Yo,
what's going on, man? Sorry about that earlier. Go ahead, you got your phone working.
You still got water.
I was hearing everything, and now the water thing's done, but it's something wrong with
y'all
over there.
Man, I just heard you perfect, man. What's going on?
That's y'all, man. As soon as you sit back in.
Yeah, it do sound
like
that.
Like you got the police over there or something.
First 48.
Hey, we ain't wide over here. I don't think so.
So you bought the beer what time?
Not yet, baby. Not yet.
Fucked up, right?
But, my brother, be telling me, man, you know, it passed to the mic, man. Look like he had something to say. And I said we kind of passed him.
Oh, yeah.
Man, you're not
going to
be trying to organize.
I know, you should be up here.
Man.
Hop in the car, come on up here, man.
You probably ain't nowhere but in Forestville, so you need to come on.
I'm
playing, dog.
I'm Saturday in the morning to go do some remediation, so I got to qualify on Friday, man. So.
All right, man, we'll talk to you later, man. We ain't got time.
Hey, that's coming from family. I ain't want to be rude. That's coming from family. We'll holler at you, though, man. Thanks for calling in, though, bro.
Ain't no thing.
All right.
So back to the credit score thing. See, my little brother does that now because, like you said, as a kid growing up, black kids, we didn't know about credit. Like most kids found out about credit in college if they were lucky to go. You know,
mm-hmm.
They get their first credit card, like you said, hit the mall. That first week is maxed out. So my little brother actually goes around and teach young kids to school and teach them credit now, like from.
That should be a course in high school.
Yeah, he does that third grade to 12. Yeah. He teaches financial, because he's a financial advisor. That's what his degree is in. And he felt like that's his job to teach our people about credit at a young age so they can get start like every other race of people do. You know?
Exactly.
Before you grab that, Wayne. Don't let Junior take us off. This is supposed to be a relationship driven.
Well, everything. It has everything.
This is about everything.
It's like all the people that's about to call in.
Oh, yeah. Look. I'm trying to get the easy stuff out the way.
Put your head on the T-ball stand right now.
We're about to rock. Go ahead, Tom.
I
was just going to say that, you know, like Zoe was saying, you know, like I knew nothing about credit. It was nothing for me to walk around in the streets with $3,000, $4,000 in my pocket.
Right.
Knew nothing about a credit card. Everything I paid for was with cash.
Right.
So, you know, when the credit, I just bought a house last year.
Right.
And they was like, you got to clean up some stuff before you do this out. I was like, I ain't even know I had
that. I still got JCPenney coming out of me. Montgomery Ward.
I blew a lot of money on credit cards. I ain't even had no credit.
Right.
Blew a lot of money on credit cards, the one for my wife, and then I had to clear all that up. So I'm good now.
Oh, no. Credit scores would definitely make you grow up quick.
We got a caller. Hold on. Go ahead, caller. What's up, bro?
And I hate to throw y'all off, Craig. I got a lot of feedback from students here. But I don't want to take y'all away. So I want to go back to this thing that's going on with you. And I got a question for y'all. How do y'all feel about the statement, peace ain't never won no land?
Say that one more time.
They're asking. So, people were out there trying to shout up last night. Mm-hmm. Some people don't agree. I agree somewhat. What y'all think?
I mean, at the end of the day, my personal opinion about that, we going to suffer the most. Because, we tearing up our own neighborhoods, and then what's going to happen? We're going to have to go shopping at.
We don't necessarily got to tear up our neighborhood, but again.
But that's what they're doing.
Every time you're peaceful, you get walked on, you get stepped on, you take your land. Oh, by the time
this is what you got to remember, though, bro. Like, when we do those type of things, when we go.
It's different in this scenario here. Nah, they've been fighting back for a long time. So now, when we get mad, the whole world will break. I think we need to keep back. Sorry.
Hey, but like the setting up our whole neighborhoods would definitely not be the problem, bro. I think a good start to that is stop supporting businesses. Because when people suffer financially, for some reason they listen. You know what I mean? Honestly, I think money right now is the root of all evil. Money has something to do with all this stuff. So I guarantee you, if you stop supporting a lot of businesses and supporting your own black businesses and starting your own black businesses and things of that nature, I honestly really, really think some of this stuff would definitely change. You know what I'm saying? Because the worst way to hurt a person is in their pockets.
In their pockets.
What people don't realize is that the world ain't gonna never get better.
Right.
But if you get into the communities will get better.
Right.
So I feel you 100% when you say hit them in the pockets.
Hit them in the pockets, man.
Because one, a lot of white people think that white people buy Timberlands and all and Nikes and
it's
all.
It's impossible.
It's us.
They can't
support all that.
We spend the most money. Yeah. We spend.
Look at the lines when the Jordans come up. And the finals come up.
If you think about it, I'm saying, like, literally, boys of both sides is weird situations, but we have a team of activists, real rap, right? So I'm going to say this. It's easy to say, like right now, if I say, man, I'm going to get 1,000 people tomorrow pissing my ass, but I bet I can do it.
Oh, yeah.
I bet I can do it.
I know you can do it.
But check it out. Them 1,000 people just going to be out there with me tomorrow. That's not going to help me with
yeah.
Right.
Come next week, huh? When I'm down there trying to rally and get some things together, whether it be through the state senators or the delegates or through the school systems, I need them same 1,000 people there to make the difference.
Yeah.
Marches do bring awareness, but it bring awareness to I think that make you look soft, and I don't mean no disrespect.
Mm-hmm. Right.
The marches is cool. What? All right, we out here. Mm-hmm. Now, come tomorrow, y'all sleep. Come on,
man. You know what I'm going to say? If the government really cared, it just may sound crazy, but if the government really, really cared, why wouldn't they give like furlough days once a week for a lot of the black people to go into their communities and give back to their communities?
Hey, a lot of jobs do, but we don't know.
Back to their communities.
Oh,
I'm paying you the day to go and say
hello.
I think if the government really, really cared, things like that would happen. They would say, you know what? Black lives do matter. All lives do matter. All black people, do me a favor. Your furlough day has to be done in your community.
Go deeper than that. I bet it's in your health plan.
Yeah.
But we ain't looked at it. We ain't ready.
Right.
We ain't ready. I bet it's in your health plan. It's mental awareness. Today I'm going to go in my community to make a difference. They're going to pay you your 8 hours. But we ain't even looked into our plan. We're looking at our sick day.
Right.
No, this is not a sick day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What is called health awareness? The military, what is called health awareness? Wellness. It's a wellness day.
Yeah, wellness.
You get paid for that.
Yeah, but that didn't happen. The community, like I said, the government really cared.
There's a lot of jobs, though.
Actually, the government does have where you can work 10-hour days and get every other Friday or every other Monday off. And then, or
I'm talking about forcing them into the community.
Why should we have to be forced into our community? You have this off day. You can take this off day.
Because a lot of people right now, honestly, a are concerned with the well-being of their family first in their household.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
True.
But now, if you force the people to say, you know, I'm going to pay you to be outside of your household to be concerned about somebody else, I think that could be a start of something possibly changing or changing the heart of some other people.
I get exactly what you're saying.
Right. But
real barbershops.
I'm the government. Fuck yeah. That ain't hurt me.
I know, right?
That's what the government is saying. Y'all, we are not hurting them at all.
Right.
We know what we're doing. They don't care about us. And to get to the marching thing, I'm sorry, I don't believe marching.
Tell me where you from first.
I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
Okay.
So I don't believe marching solves anything. Because, first off, you have the right to protest. True.
Right.
But what does a march do? They set up, they block this street, and let you walk down this way. So you can't block these people from going on about their day. You're not stopping or changing anything that other people are doing.
I got to disagree with that. You know why I want to disagree? Man, I'm going to tell you why. The reason why I disagree with that, because at some point in time, you got to bring the awareness to the cause. And I think the march is not to say this is the solution. I think the march is saying we need to bring awareness to the problem.
Okay. But awareness to the problem has been done since 1960.
And that's where the march was powerful. That's where the march was powerful. Right. Today is social media.
But, right.
We got to be different.
And y'all killing the camera person.
Oh, my fault.
The whole thing is that we've been doing the same thing for years. Marching. Getting on TV, talking about it.
Right.
Nobody's doing shit, though. Nobody's doing nothing. Nobody's getting up and saying, okay, these thousand people out here, let's clean up this neighborhood. Let's pick up these papers. Let's pay these bills. Let's do something about these boarded up houses in our community. We can't expect somebody to come from the outside, inside our neighborhoods to clean them up.
And that's kind of piggybacks on the
conversation. Exactly. I understand. But it's like I said, I agree with you 150%.
Right.
But my thing is, why should somebody have to force us to take care of us?
I don't think a lot of us want to go back to our communities. You believe that? Let me say, it was a lady.
Keep
it at 100.
I mean, you know exactly. You're right. It was a lady in the town hall meeting. I ain't gonna say her name, but she's very prominent in the area. Was it the C Pleasant rep? 95 was out there, the man was out there, everybody was out there. The lady straight up was powerful. I was in there, and that's it's hard to reach me. So I'm sitting like, oh, she killing it. She got my heart. And she said, and I left this community and I never come back.
That's what it is.
She lost me.
Yeah.
I'm like, Shorty.
That's what killed
her. You're the most powerful voice in right now. And you just told everybody that lives here that you will never come back.
But that's something
we've been taught. We've been taught to get money and get out of the neighborhood.
Yeah. You get yours.
But this is what I will say though. It's nothing wrong with getting your money and leaving.
No.
The problem is not coming back. It's not making a difference.
It helps somebody else out.
There's nothing wrong with putting your children in the best schools to get the best education.
Absolutely.
But you're teaching your children we still got to help our brothers. We still got to help our sisters. We still got to feed the homeless, whatever you want to instill in your household. So there's nothing wrong with you making out your neighborhood. The problem is not going back trying to do something about it to change.
And that comes in with, they say, you know, I got mine, so you got to get yours. Instead of it being, I got mine, so let me show you how you get yours.
Right.
Hey, but I'm going to be the ass again. You got those that's back in the neighborhood trying mess up yours.
Pull you down.
Yeah.
So you gotta help the ones that wanna be helped.
Send them to me. I promise.
Look at some of our local celebrity basketball players.
Drop a name, my dude.
I respect it. You know, because they did good and they try to come back, but the people back brought them back down.
I invited all of them to Project Peace, Prince George's County, where I had 400 plus kids there.
And I seen it. I seen the pictures.
Right.
It's a free event.
For free.
You know how many of them came out?
None.
Zero.
Yeah. None.
Zero. Not one. Last year, we know who came out? Quinn Cook. Out of the love of his heart. Shout out to Quinn.
Shout out to Quinn Cook. I seen him giving back a couple times. So.
Out of the love of his heart, straight from Duke Championship. Like, so my man, what you mean?
Hey, why don't we give a shout out? Raheem Devon.
Shout out to Raheem, too.
Yeah. Can't forget about him.
That's what he do, though.
Yeah. But
they hate him, and I love him.
Like,
get back on subject. Like, you said that, you know, why don't they give back? It's embedded in us for some reason that it's every man for themselves. It's every man for themselves. We have not, the problem is in our community, there is no community.
But do you think that goes back to slavery?
Amen.
Yes.
No.
I'm just asking. Some people don't think that.
No, I disagree with it. I don't think it's slavery. I think it's a little bit further up than slavery, where they have still this divide and conquer towards now. After
so, you don't believe slavery?
I disagree with that too.
Let me tell you where it started in slavery: house niggas and field niggas. You make one nigga feel better than the other nigga.
That's
you
true.
Feel like he you're a slave.
That's where I'm coming from. Hold on, but they disagree with us. Hold on.
In their mind, in a brainwashed mind, I'm not. They are slaves. I live in a big house with boss.
I don't think all niggas was like that.
Well, we couldn't really say that. But hold on. But y'all disagree. I need to know why y'all disagree.
I'm gonna tell you why I disagree.
But we together though.
Because in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, the first gangs, I guess you could say Bloods, Crips, you could say the Black Panther Party, those type of organizations.
They were community based.
The government made them out to be gangs or the violent people, but they actually cared about their community. And that's how, why you think we got where we are today? Somebody had to pay the price. Somebody had to organize. And with that being said, that's why I disagree. We had that. I think it went away from them when drugs hit our neighborhoods. I think it went away from because now
that's the era I'm talking about.
The separation of that timeline of this though.
This is what I do. I love this. I'm gonna tell you something.
Bombshop historian.
Yes.
It's always one.
But I'm gonna tell you, like, it was starting with the house nigga and the field niggas. When we got free, everybody was trying to help each other. That's true. Everybody was trying to, all black people trying to help each other. They were really trying to help each other. Then you get down into, like you said, the 50s and 60s, where you had white cops coming into the neighborhood, beating black people, hanging and lynchings and everything. Right. So the gangs did get formed. They were formed to protect the neighborhood.
But they came together. That's the part where I disagree.
They did come together. They formed and they came together. But the mindset of a gang mentality. Now we got power. Now we run this neighborhood. That mindset set in. No, that's when you become bullies of the neighborhood.
That changed when drugs hit the neighborhood.
Go back to the beginning of the Crips and Bloods. The Bloods were only formed because the Crips was destroying the neighborhoods. Look at the history of the Bloods and the Crips. The Bloods formed.
That's a different era. You went from.
But that's the Black Panther Party to Bloods and Crips. Let me go to the Black Panther Party. 10 by 10 same time, it's a different coast. The Black Panther Party was there, they was helping the community, everything. Like you said, the federal government came in and they did what they did to the Black Panther Party, broke them up. Federal agents was embedded to infiltrate them and try to prove that they doing something wrong when they wasn't. They were just protecting. They were feeding homeless. They was, helping women pay bills. They were doing all this stuff for the community.
And that's why that's usually the argument about it.
True. But the mindset, it's only a few of them that was up for that fight. Because you still got that brother that has a little money and a good job that's saying, I don't know why these niggas acting like that.
I think all that's BS, huh? Because all of us was raised in a probably 6-year vicinity, right? Ain't no way that I can say what happened to somebody 3 years prior to me is gonna make me today. So I can't say that none of that happened because of slavery. No question. Because look, we was all raised by the people I know in my vicinity, either a single parent. Mm-hmm. Drug dealers, yeah. Pimps, yeah. Or somebody just straight street, somebody in the street.
Right.
I did that for a small part of my life,
right.
And made a choice.
We all did.
So I can't say that none of that is a reason why things are the way they are.
I agree. I've been through the worst. You can be a victim of circumstance.
Well, you could be a victim of getting hit in the street by a cop.
Well, no, because see, like, I got a homeboy. He caught his first crack charge when he was 11. Now, the only way you can catch a crack charge at 11 is if you live in a neighborhood where people buy crack from 11-year-olds. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you don't live in a neighborhood where they buy crack from 11-year-olds, you cannot get arrested for selling crack. It's hard.
Let me take this call real quick. Go ahead, call him.
Hi, I'm
Unrestricted
Radio.
What's up? Hey, how y'all doing? Hey, this is like a party line back in the day. Y'all try to show face like.
Hi, boys of both
sides. Hey.
Hey, Smokey.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm well.
So what's your question?
First of all, I'm going to tell y'all, y'all are doing a great job in my acting.
I got all psyched. Oh, what's up, Mo? Like,
he thought you was some bait.
I thought you was the bait. I was like, man, we really doing good. But hey, Mo, how you doing? What's up, girl?
Y'all are doing an awesome job.
Why, thank you, Mo.
We're sitting here listening to you all, and y'all are
doing
an awesome job. We had a question. As a man, do you all have an issue with a woman that you're dating if
she's
making more money than you?
Oh, hell no.
All right, hold on.
Hell no.
Hold on.
All right, hold on. All right, so look, moving forward.
Hell no.
Let's keep it down to a minimum and give everybody a chance to answer this starting with Zoba one on around. Back to me.
There you go.
Hell no. Next question.
No issue at all.
None.
Let me be the sentiment to your Oprah.
I'm a good one. That one is. No way in the world. Nah.
I'm a secure, and I can be a secure kept man. If the Mo, I know you're taking, but if the girl next to you got a good government job and she's looking for, it's winter time, she might need a chubby teddy bear. I'm right here.
I agree with the rest of the fellas. I had no problem with that either.
Hold on, can I piggyback off that for the fellas real quick?
Oh, go ahead, brother.
Let me ask you a question. If your woman makes more money than you, are you still expected to pay half the bills?
That was a good question. It just came up, too.
He said, if your girl makes more money than you, are you still expected to pay half the bills? Mo, what you think about that?
Oh, yeah.
I knew you were going to say yeah.
If you have the capabilities, yeah. Because every man don't got their drive, Joe.
I agree.
If you have the capabilities, yeah. You know your man.
Yeah.
He either go get or he not. If he not, he chose to be with him. But me, I've been in a position where I didn't have. I've been with my lady 11 years. And it was a time where I was short. Mm-hmm. But guess what? I still paid more than half.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but me personally, what I would do, I would still pay half. And I would say, baby, I'm bad with money. I need you to bank the rest of that. Whatever you got, handle the finances. I'm bad with money. I'm not gonna lie. Mm-hmm. If I got $200 left in my pocket and I was starving on some shoes, I'm gonna be fresh.
The devil is a liar.
Hey, I'm telling you too. I don't even know how much money I make for real.
Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that.
My money goes straight to the account. My lady, she pays the bills, whatever's right, left. She right. Tell me what's left.
I'm learning this. What's up?
I'll let her take care of that.
Tony?
Tony, like, I don't know about the joint count thing.
Nah, I would feel less of a man if I didn't do something. Like,
right, exactly.
Like, I know a lot of dudes that they not making that money like their women.
Right.
But they cooking for the kids. They make sure the kids do homework. You got to pick up somewhere else. You can't
cut the grass. I got a
follow-up question for that.
Oh, go ahead, brother.
I got a follow-up question for that. So, and this is for Mo. Is if you making more money than your man, do you still? Is he still king of the castle?
Do
you still pay to see your man?
Is that a question for her? Or is that a question?
That's a question for her first, and then the fellas.
Okay, all right.
I would say yes, as long as he's handling the household and he's.
So long as he maintains the household, he can be the king of the household. Yeah.
So what about your back?
Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying he's not just going to be working at Dollar Tree and coming in and saying he running shit.
Why?
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 That's hard work.
Because if you're not matching your capabilities, like, come on, dog.
So hold on.
That's that new woman shit.
So hold on. Hold on, Mo. If I'm the manager of Dollar Tree, right? I work in D.C. The minimum wage just kicked in, so I'm making extra money. I can't come in and be like, baby, where the food at? You know what I'm saying? Can I get a little back rub or something? You know, I've been standing up all day at the register.
I'm going to hold you down. I'm going to hold you down, but you got to hold it down in our house.
For how long?
Forever.
Okay, radio.
I didn't even sound radio. Mo, you taking us off topic, Mo.
Well, we like to wish you a happy birthday, Mo, and thank you for calling in the Unrestricted Barbershop Lounge. But we don't like your answer no more. Bye, say. Hey, who's there with you?
Tiffany.
Hey, Tiffany. Is that the one with the pretty edges that was up here last week? Okay. Hey, Tiffany. Y'all getting y'all hair wet because you know I love when black girls get their hair wet. Yeah.
Take Tiffany to go buy some tennis shoes too.
But I'm listening. Well, this is what I will say. I'm gonna close that question out with this. Like real life, my man Big Nigga just posted, right? But I mean, I'm gonna put a little something on that. I don't care what job you work, what you do in life. If you live in a house with a woman, biblically, you are always the head of the house.
Oh boy. You hear that, Mo?
And a good woman will submit.
All right, Mo. Take care, baby.
A good woman will submit to a great leader. Good. I don't care. I could be making $5 an hour and she making 20.
Right.
But you're the man.
You gotta be a great leader.
That's why I said.
You gotta be a great leader.
Hold on, fellas.
You can't be a chump.
Right.
Unrestricted Radio Show.
Hold up. What's your name? You want to give your name?
Go ahead. Ask your question. Go ahead.
My question is, how long, as a man, if you go to jail, do you expect for women to wait for you?
Did
she say jail?
Yes. I'm not going to jail.
She said, how long are you expecting a woman to wait for you if you go to jail?
3 days. I'm not going to jail.
That's innate.
Not applicable.
It depends. Hold on. We gotta get some more. I know we're in the barbershop, but go ahead, though.
All right, look, I'm gonna answer.
We gotta do it quick, fellas, because we got hour and 10 minutes left.
All right, devil's advocate. I'm not going to jail, so you ain't gotta wait on me, baby. I'll be home in a little bit.
Okay.
But secondly, for a man that does go to jail, if this man was your rock while you was out, you should be his rock while he's in.
Something like that.
You?
Exactly. What if he's been my mom for so many
years, but
he gets
15?
Hey, you know what he messed up at? She said the butt and the only. If you got a butt and only in your relationship, then that's your answer for real. But Zoe really said it. It depends on really where you are in that relationship.
Right.
If that person is yours, you wouldn't even question it.
True.
Right. But I feel the same way. I was about to say it depends where you are. If you 1 year in, I don't know. If how long are you supposed to wait? If you married and you've been down, like, you know, that's your folks, like you said, you wouldn't even have to answer that question. You wouldn't have to ask.
Tony? I don't even think that's a real question because a real dude ain't gonna be like wait on me. Like, she's gonna do whatever she wanted to do regardless.
Anyway.
You in jail, you don't know what's going on. She's gonna clean it up when you get out.
Right.
So that's not your rock, that's your pebble, baby.
Right.
I'm not going to jail, but if I go to jail, it'll be for her or my kids.
Right.
Now, some of you better wait. Ain't no question. You better wait because that's the only reason I'm going to jail.
If I go to jail for protecting my wife and kids and I get locked up, you gonna fuck out of both parents' slaves.
Let me ask you a quick question. Do y'all got kids?
Yes.
No.
Three beautiful ones. I love my babies.
Caller.
Do y'all have kids, Caller?
Yes.
How many?
Two.
And you say y'all been together for a year?
Yes.
And he's gone for 15?
Yes.
And both those kids is?
What's your number?
Hold on.
Psych, I'm gonna ask it.
If you said you've been there for...
I'm playing. I'm going to home training.
If he's gone for 15 years, I'm with Tony, like... Just clean that up before you get out.
That's all you can do. I mean, 15 years, that's going to be a long 15 years.
Yeah.
I mean, you can probably get
15 for college convention, so y'all talking to BC jail last.
They moving them around.
Oh, she does. I clean it up when she get out, but I'm keeping 100. Sorry, fella.
You're not gonna give me the answer to that.
This is all my answer. I mean, hey, I'm sorry. Don't judge me when I say this. I'm gonna say it like this. Women have sex out of emotion. A good woman.
Yeah.
So you got some women out here.
Loose booty.
There you go.
But can't trust that. Say, say.
No, but a good woman, when she loses herself to a man, somehow he has her mentally, emotionally. A man can have sex with a woman and feel nothing. Don't
no connection. No connection.
So
he might not have been even knew your name.
Hold on, we only got a little bit of time.
All right, so I'm gonna grab it up. So that being said, I feel like a man, if he's dealing with a woman while a woman is incarcerated, and he's really in love with you. She means nothing. And he can cut off at any minute.
They said you're not touching, right?
Let me flip the question one time. What if it was your wife?
Oh, my wife is something different.
My wife is something different.
I'm going to go with that. Right.
I was speaking, you know what? I'm not going to put this bullshit in.
What if you got 15 years and it was your wife, though? You expect her to wait?
She
better not dip out. Yeah. Hey. If it's my wife, then yeah.
I think I'm a little different. I think I'm just different.
I hear some double standards in here.
Man, probably after my 10th year, I'll probably be like, go ahead, baby.
Get one body in there.
It
would
just
about
tell my wife to be honest. I'll be honest. I might tell her to go ahead, man.
Not to you.
I gotta take it that way. You been locked up before?
No.
I ain't gonna ask. But you got
we been locked up. Me and him been locked up.
you can't sit here and think about this. You better off telling her. You know you got 15 years. Do what you do.
Just don't bring no babies.
Yeah. Right. Wait.
And the news reverse. Yeah. I'm gonna tell her this, y'all. I might just have to tell you now.
I was gonna get a little head, not that much. She's like, I just let her pop. I let her get one at 2 times. Pop, pop. That was it. She didn't finish.
I don't know. 15 years, because like I said, I'm going for you, and you don't know. No, this is your fucking jail time.
But you gonna cheat in jail?
Okay, since we getting on relationship, we're going to take a commercial break right now because, you know, we've been going an hour in of barbershop talk, but we're going to get back into the good stuff.
Unrestricted radio.
The real good stuff.
Man, this is actually so good that people are hitting me up right now trying to text their questions, and you need to email them because you can't be texting me like right now because we don't do that at Unrestricted Radio. Hold up. They want to know, do Dwayne say?
Hey, I appreciate you calling, sweetie. Thanks.
We'll be right back, Facebook Live.
We'll be right back. We coming back with y'all. Come on, y'all. This is Unrestricted, y'all. Wednesdays are Unrestricted. We'll be right back.
I wasn't doing that.
We got like 45 questions.
We're about to go away and bring it to the
door. This is going to happen.
No, that's but it's good though, because
you would. Y'all thought you political rapper, like, oh, that was going to take some time.
Yeah.
I ain't going to lie, I was going to try to stay away from that, because I know that can be a challenge.
But the good thing about it, we got some good dudes to talk about it.
Yeah, I'm saying we got the right people. Yeah, I'm saying we got the right people.
Yeah, but it wasn't nothing attacking white people, nothing like that.
No, it's about us. That's what it was. Yeah, it was about us.
It wasn't like we were talking about gays or nothing like that, or shit like that.
Radio Wednesdays are unrestricted. We up in this joint, back at it with the all guys barbershop lounge.
Damn.
Phone off the hook.
They was waiting.
They percolating on that phone right now. Go ahead, turn that joint. This is, we're gonna take this one and then we're gonna go directly into the email question.
Unrestricted radio show. Uh-oh. Unrestricted radio show.
Unrestricted.
Hey, what's up, bro?
What's going on? No, yeah, we just coming back from break. Yeah.
Okay. Now we
start. Huh? Okay.
Okay. Rich, he calling up here checking. He's like, oh, y'all just coming back from break. All right. That's the station manager right there. He's a wild boy.
All right, listeners. Hey, I'm going to put this disclaimer out there. Wives, girlfriends, side chicks.
Almost side chick, almost baby mother. Things.
Don't catch no feelings with nobody because it's about to get real unrestricted right now.
Oh, no, let's get
real unrestricted.
I'm apologizing for now. Sorry, y'all.
Sorry. Sorry.
All right. I got is a wife and all.
I don't know about no thoughts, no side chick, no head bumps.
No trips. Okay, so since y'all started it all.
They call her Stephanie. I call her Stephanie.
All right, come on, fellas. We only got a little time.
All right, let's go.
Question number one. Are you in a relationship?
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely no.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
That's damn.
That was cool. Go ahead.
What's worse, betrayal from your boy or betrayal from your girl?
Hold on. This is what I'm going to say. Let me come with that. I don't give a damn about a betrayal from my girl, but betrayal from my wife would be much more hurtful than betrayal from one of my boys. But if it was one of my boys that just had a girlfriend, betrayal from my boy would hurt more because the loyalty to your brothers.
Boy.
Exact same answer.
Your boy?
That's not what you said, but
I mean, you know. I mean,
my homie. Put him. My homie, because I feel like I hold him to a higher standard than a chick that ain't man.
I agree with Zoe.
I don't roll with Zoe. Well, that's because I don't have a wife, so it's like, you know, wife or boy, I would choose wife. But my homie, I feel like I hold my homie to a higher standard, like, you know. I don't know.
Hold on, let me ask you, because I'm a little different. Because I don't really get that many close boys.
Right, right.
I'm going to be honest. I mean, you know. But
if I can see you my close boy, you can ruin me. if you're my close boy, you could literally ruin me. I mean, like, I probably couldn't even get a job. I'd be like one of the people that post racist stuff on Facebook, and then they call your job and be like, "This would." You could literally ruin everything about me if you're my closest homie. Like,
I agree. All right, so question. Let's see.
But then again, your wife could too. She started telling stories about the little time you peed in the bed when you was drunk and stuff. You know?
Oh.
Okay.
Speaking of children, when a man has children from a previous relationship, does his new woman come second to his kid's mother?
Wow.
Sheesh.
Want to come back to it?
Yeah, let me think about that.
Pass.
Circumstantial mind, my lady come before my ex.
No, he said before the children. He said before the
baby mother.
Before the baby mother.
Oh, baby mother, hell no. I thought you said kids. I thought you baby mother, she got to go. I mean, it's not my first lady.
The new lady. Right. First lady?
Yeah, of course.
First lady.
The first lady.
My baby mother, you see, so I'm good.
Yeah, my lady now.
Of course, that's not.
But that's kind of a touchy subject. I mean, I get what y'all were saying, but it kind of depends on the fact that, like,
it's circumstantial.
Yeah,
it's circumstantial because if that
I'm gonna say my lady, but like BJ said,
if my kid over there,
her boyfriend beating shit out of him,
that's not putting your second lady second.
My child is there.
What you just said is not putting your current girlfriend before.
If I'm laying beside him and I'm getting up and get go,
that's
go
out, safety. That's something totally different.
No,
you go your baby mother call you and say, man, look. Your girlfriend, blah 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 blah. That's how you really.
But you get what I'm saying? Like, what you're saying to me, like, I'm gonna say I love everybody. If I ever love you, I'm always love you. Like, as a person, as a human being. Mm-hmm. So, hear me out. You're telling me that you're putting, say, if I'm in a new relationship with a new woman, and I got children by another woman. And her baby father or her new boyfriend is beating her up in front of your children, that's slighting your new girlfriend? That's not the case.
No, hold on.
Your new girlfriend might not understand.
How can she not understand?
Because
first of all, she don't need to be your girlfriend. She can't understand. No. This nigga's beating her up in front of your children. And your children are watching their mother.
No, I'm not saying it like that. What I'm saying is.
Okay.
Right, that's what I'm saying. If it's an altercation going on at my baby's mama's house.
Hold on. Okay. This is a good one. Going on after baby mother house, but the kids at your house.
That's not my bad.
Oh, no, she does.
She got called her brother.
That's how you ask that.
But I'm saying if my kid is
there. No, she got called her brother.
But your kid's going to go back there. Your kid's going to go back there.
That is true, too.
So the kids at your house on a Saturday night, your baby mama call you and be like, can you help me? This came to be crazy and beat my ass.
I sure will.
911.
They over there beating on her. I'm not leaving.
You better go get Harpo.
All right, so let's go to the next question. I'm just going to go down the line. They're going to be random questions all over the place. Why do men work hard to get a woman to let her down, let her guard down, but then it makes it seem like she is thirsty once she shows interest?
So.
Bam. Okay, well, let's
go.
Men have a lion type attitude, like fierce competitive inside of them.
Correct.
So we want to conquer, and not only want to conquer, our job is to make it feel like, Shawty, you belong to me. You see what I'm saying? So even if it's just somebody that you just like messing around with, whatever the case may be, every nigga want to feel like he that nigga.
Territorial.
You see what I'm saying? And that's the reason why. And sometimes after you conquer too goddamn quick, because she gave up too goddamn quick, I think maybe the situation with you may just very well may lose interest.
Okay. We go to BJ.
I'm gonna make it personal. I don't really think it's a lose interest though sometimes, Joe. Because once I conquer, I got you, we good, everything flowing. It's not gonna let my guards down. Now I can focus on something else. Might be my credit. Our relationship good. Yeah, we good. But some females, no disrespect females, but that's why we having this conversation.
Right,
they confuse that let your god down with not caring. Sure, I still love you to death. But I can't be boo-booing you all day now. I got to move on.
Yeah. Right.
Smoke.
I disagree with what Zoe says. You can never give it up too fast, ladies. Never. Sometimes that helps the situation. Sometimes I'm chasing, I'm like, dang, how long you gonna... All right, let me just... I got time. I got to be to work tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? So, no, honestly, I think that you never give it up too soon. We don't lose interest. Sometimes, like you said, we have to do other things. And sometimes y'all just want us to chase too damn much.
Yeah.
I'm about to. Y'all bullshit.
I'm telling that they want us to chase all day long, and you know, like I don't know, man. It's, for me, I'm not gonna chase you all day long. You know, especially if you gave it up quick.
Gino,
I have to tell you the truth. So if I'm chasing you just off your looks, and I haven't like had an in depth conversation with you,
right.
Soon as I bust, I'm done. My mind is clear.
Say, as soon as you come,
I'm telling you, that's what it comes down to. That's men.
Right.
That's men, period.
Right.
If you going to have sex with me, off of us just seeing each other and having a quick conversation in the club or something, or just bullshitting around, like, it wasn't nothing to begin with, for real.
Okay.
Yeah. Most of the time, for me, it's something that she keep doing that turns me off. So, that's why I don't think it. Thinking about getting quick, just her herself, yeah, just... I don't like the nagging, I don't like the insecurity, but I don't like
the insecurity.
It was cool before you hit, though.
Even if she showed me before that, I would be falling back.
I've had some of my friends going to this type of situation here. Shorty thought she was like that, and it was so on her high horses. He broke her down. He's the one to break her down because she was a high horse.
And I've had homeboys do that too.
That's a case of a woman putting her representative up and not being herself at first.
That's true. Let me take this call real quick, though. Hold on. Call him, go ahead.
Yes, I have a question for the guy.
Guys or we, guy? Sorry,
guys.
Okay. Okay.
What's the question? Anyone, and then I would hang up in here to hear an answer.
Okay.
Would you rather have a woman that is compatible with you, meaning they understand your hustle, meaning your business, they understand if you have children, have no problem, all your sports, your activity, anything that you like, and that you do, things
like that too.
Or would you rather have somebody, okay, now I gotta get in a life, the sport, I gotta get an understand my household, you know, or would you just rather
have like that is compatible like that, the life is something
that you do,
understand,
or
like
somebody you gotta mold and shape.
So will we,
or is it too
good
to be true?
So pretty much to answer your question, you asked us, do we want somebody ready made or somebody that we can
turn into something that we can build up?
You say, right?
I'll give you an example.
I mean, not trying to be rude, but just in a quick, in a nutshell.
Real quick, if you, like y'all do what y'all do, and I say, smoking y'all always at the station, you just stay all the time, you don't have no time, that means that I don't understand your business, I don't understand what your profession is. How long are we going to be together? Not long. But if I know that you, that's your career, that's your passion, I got your back. What's the problem?
I want somebody that already know the grind, because like I'm a musician. So if you don't know that I'm in a studio at night, and I mean don't know how long I'm in a studio or doing this and doing that, then you become insecure. Who you with? Who you doing this with? Who you that? I need that person that already know the grind. Now you can not have a lot of the grind, But most of the grind, if you know that whole struggle of what I'm doing, or that whole hustle of what I'm doing and everything that I need, like my wife didn't know nothing about musicians or nothing. Ooh. She didn't know that at all. So she was kind of green, but because of her security, she trusted me. Yeah, she trusts me up to now.
She knows pretty quick. Okay, I'll keep that clap up and down the East Coast.
Just for the record, we're going to be doing a seminar each month.
Yeah. We're going to send the Eventbrite information and PayPal information.
No, but let's talk, man. We got 5 people. So I'm trying to get some feedback on that.
All right, we're going to give you 5 more comments, but listen, we're going to have to cut you off, but we're going to have more comments, all right?
Bye.
I'm gonna tell you the truth. I'd rather somebody not, because that's you owe the person you with. It doesn't matter if she know the grind or not. It's trusting. It's the whole trusting. If she knows the grind, I still gotta make her feel comfortable, and I have to feel comfortable with her. There's extra things you do to make a person feel comfortable about what you're doing. So it doesn't matter if she know the grind or don't know the grind. It's about how far are you going to go to make this person feel comfortable about what you're doing.
I agree. Smoke.
It depends how old she is. If she's young, I'm older. If she's already older, I just wanted to understand.
Yeah, that's good point.
I mean, if I'm keeping it real.
That's true.
That's true.
I think, to me, it's really what I'm looking for right now at the time. If I'm looking for a strong relationship, I really don't care which one of them you feel. Which field you're in. Do you love me? I'm going to be together. But if not,
so.
I think, me personally, I just want a woman that's understanding. You know what I mean? So, like, even if you're not into football, but you won't throw in that Redskins jersey because you know I like that Redskins. You know what I mean? Wow. I want that's supportive. So, regardless of what type of woman you are, first of all, But I'm giving an example for the, like, on a real note. Like, it doesn't matter whether you're into sports or you're into. If you want to support whatever I'm into and say, baby, I got your back for whatever that you do, you don't have to be. You don't have to be into throwing parties. You don't have to be into sports. You don't have to be into bands and go-go's and radio stations. But guess what, babe? I know that's what you like. Go ahead.
I was though 100% on that. Let me take this call real quick. Go ahead, caller.
Unrestricted.
I can speak.
Go ahead.
All right, first you put. First thing first, I want to say shout out to all y'all. I'm digging the whole Breakfast Club group, the whole karate guys getting together, so I love it. But I have a question, man. Let me say what happened to me. I'm on Facebook. I won't put my name out there. Actually, I looked through Facebook with very quite popular. She we hooked up. She thought I was attracted. I thought she was attracted to me. Went out to a nice basketball court. But I didn't realize how popular she was, because when we went out to a restaurant, every nigga that we call it in this Facebook was coming and say, hey, what's up? What's up? So I want to ask you on that. How do y'all feel about dating a woman when you first, I guess when you see her as a Facebook woman, y'all think she's too fine, attractive, but she's gone. But yet still, we got one cover. You realize she's got 50 niggas through the club.
Hey, all right, we're going to answer this real quick one by one. Start with me. Honestly, as long as they ain't bodies, I don't care.
Body.
I mean, because she could be popular, she could be an entertainer, she could be throw parties, just know all the drug dealers, no way. As long as she ain't got no bodies on them, I'm good. So.
I gotta agree with you, man. Like, as long as Shane fuck out of both pants legs and niggas that knock the butt out quick, I'll dance for it.
But you know, man, can I just...
Hold on. Let everybody answer real quick. Go ahead, B.
Oh, quick.
She better be introducing me.
That's a good point too.
Ooh, that's a real good point. That's a good point. The introduction.
But that was after. I don't be knowing everybody's speaking to me, though. So I can't really introduce you.
Yes, you can. I do it all the time. Yes, you can. No, I don't know, though.
No, for real. I like about me being throwing parties and playing ball and all that. You know what I'm saying? We interact with so many people on a daily basis. So, like, anytime I see somebody, even if I don't remember who they are, I will act like I know them to make them feel good. But I also will say, and this is my wife.
Yeah, you know, and another thing, but we gonna get to y'all. But another thing, I want everybody to know who my lady is. Me personally,
that's true.
Because dog, real talk, the nigga in me, like, if anything go down, I don't have nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna know my peeps.
I get that. I get
you
that.
Know what I'm saying? I only selected people gonna really know.
She gonna tell my that.
Nah, she not if she trained.
Zing! For me, I would, like I said, I feel the same way. As long as she ain't, it ain't all bodies. If she is not, like he said, fucking our left pants leg, and everybody done had that thing, and you know.
I agree.
And I'm gonna let go, but it's something about this area for some strange reason, actually. If I find that we have a lounge or functional or funky thing that someone got going on, and I see this woman, she's attractive, she's cute, she's such a storm, and then I have to be ashamed of the woman that we walk, and then after that, we walk, and then one more time,
and I want to show you that I'm saying, you know, something, you know, something, I'm like, ah. They hit you with an ass. I'll be like, sometimes you
got
to say you don't know people.
But to be honest,
depending on how fat they is.
Maybe the compliment.
you know Dwayne? Nah, I don't know that. But ain't you on the radio? Nah, I don't know them like that. That's my first time.
Hey, you might just got a good looking chick, though, man, for real.
I'm going to tell you, long as she ain't disrespected, she ain't let nobody disrespect us while we standing there, or, you know, like, ain't got all them damn bodies on her, you know, and she ain't disrespectful, I'm good.
Exactly. You better ask questions when she asks you. Hey, but we gotta go, man. Thanks for calling in with that.
If she know Dwayne, don't mess with her.
You better know it. All right, so let me see what I got here. Oh, now we about to get into this. So why do men always want a male and a two female threesome, but not two male and a female one?
First of all. All
right, quick, because we winding down. Go ahead.
A threesome is not with two guys and a girl. That's a train. Yes. It's totally different. Don't you sit there and talk that, oh, we had a threesome. No, you got good. So, basically, I don't want it because men and men will touch each other. Yeah. So that's not a threesome. That's them touching you.
Me?
Perfect damn answer. But true story, man, look. It's not going to happen unless you have them tendencies to be on that side of that fence.
I disagree. I think there's two types of threesomes. Our threesome is a straight man's threesome is two women.
Correct.
Some women that are not into women, because every woman is not bisexual, a threesome for them is with two men.
No, a man and a girl, though. She won't get two men.
No, I'm just saying. It don't have to be your girl, though. It don't have to be your girl. This could be a random. And like you said.
First of all, I don't think nobody can really do one with the girl. It ain't gonna be my girl.
They might. You heard about you heard about Kendu, Mary J. Blige's husband. He was doing some stuff like that.
I'm talking about from two guys and a girl.
That's what he was texting chicks asking, can me and my homeboy get it in?
No, I can't do that. But you asked.
I ain't never been that type of dude, really. I'm not Shan one, and I'm not soul fighting, so I don't need to go down like that.
You know.
I get that. Hey, first off, I ain't gonna be in Nick in the same room with you. That's first off. So, like, if it's two men and a woman, that's a train, because we taking turns.
Right.
Like,
right.
I'm here. I'm going out.
I mean,
only time you take a high five and go away.
Now, even if you're in a room and you're having two dudes are having sex with one chick, one, you know, bobbing dude off. Yeah. There's always a three foot circle. Like, hey, cook, hey, you know what I'm saying? Cook, watch yourself. Cook, you know what I'm saying? Like,
stay in your circle.
Yeah, you stay. You never turn the lights off in a real train.
Some dudes comfortable with being in a room with another naked man. Like, it's natural for a man to say. It's natural for a man. We in the same house. I'm getting out the shower. Me and you in the same house, though. I'm getting out the shower. I left my towel in the room. I'm not going to say, hey, Zoe, go get my towel for me.
Let's
go to the next question. All right, fellas, let's go to the next question.
You better wrap up in the rug.
All right, so look. All right, here we go. Why do men send unsolicited sexual pictures to women on social media?
Can I go first?
So the dick pic. Hold on, so you're going to start with you and go that way. Yeah. Go ahead, B.
Man, that's the
You got the worm, right?
That's that fish. You see if they bite. They bite.
I think it's more of a situation where what you're trying to do is say, look, you ain't even got a guess. This is what I'm working with. If you want it, come get me. Yeah. I don't feel that way for real because I'm married.
But if you would like, hypothetically.
There you go.
Me personally, I'm proud of what I got, so I don't mind showing it. Next.
Oh, no, you went that way.
No, because the camera's still here.
Oh, okay. So, me, I don't mind. I'll do it if she asks for it. I won't do it unsolicited because I feel like that's alias.
I'm telling you the truth. I feel like ugly niggas do that.
Hold up.
That's true.
Hold on, what do you mean?
Because I'm kind of ugly, but I got a big dick, though.
Or just randomly saying it?
No, just randomly saying it.
Oh, yeah, nah.
If she asked for it, oh, it's coming.
Not randomly, no, but.
Like if you randomly, I might be ugly, but I got something.
And you gonna see the Joe? I might look fucked up.
Yeah, I ain't never mind doing that.
Like, you know, when you're working with, you know, like you ain't tripping off that.
She hit you back and be like, man.
Like me take the picture. Come over here and take the picture yourself.
I mean, well, you gotta think about it. It's a thing of the times now. It's easy. You can just you got your phone. Bow. Think about back in the day, how hard everything was. Like. What you gonna take a Polaroid? You like, you got to be holding a big box. Like, you like, oh, when she get this joint, boy, shaking the shit out your wrist. Like, you blowing her. She gonna get this one.
All right, so let's go to another question. All right, do men get tired of being the aggressor in the bedroom? So
yes, of course. I mean, we are definitely pleasers. A man is definitely pleaser because we want to stand in the mirror and look at ourselves and be sweating like we did that. But sometimes we want to do the biggie joke like, get on top, biggie.
Biggie?
I won't say tired, but I say, and I ain't doing it all the time.
I don't want to always be the aggressor. Sometimes I want to feel like you going to take it. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, I'm tired. Come get this joint. I don't feel like doing that.
I like it when my wife rough me. I love it.
Hey, she rough you over that joint. Good.
What time you leave here?
I'm going to tell you, it's all about feeling wanted too. So if a woman comes and takes it from you, you feel like, yeah, she won't this.
Yeah, right, exactly.
So
that's validation.
Okay.
Validation.
I'm with you on that one. Like, I want to be one. You know, I don't want to be the one, give me that pussy all the time. You know, I'm like, hey, give me that.
Wait.
Alright, so
push me against the wall and then take it from me. Just take it, girl.
Maybe we love you more.
Baby, right, he's gonna touch you one.
We gonna, this is a touchy one, but we're gonna keep it quick. Should your spouse have passwords and access to all your accounts?
I'm going through that right now.
Okay, so
touchy subject.
But I'm gonna speak on it.
Because you know, we do give you the option here.
We do
give you the option. Like, if you got a court case, you can't talk about it while you're inside the court case.
I'm going to speak on it because it's been a very touchy subject in my relationship. It's kind of, you know, had us on the rocks, man. So I'm going to say this. I don't think you should have the passwords. But I also think that we shouldn't always keep our phone face down.
I'm just talking about an emergency.
You said spouse. You didn't say girlfriend, boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? So I'm talking from a married man's perspective. I think that, and this is my opinion, and my wife thinks differently. But I have to still give my opinion.
Because your opinion counts.
Your wife ain't here.
Especially here.
No, your wife ain't here, Zoe.
If your opinion you don't count nowhere, Zoe, it count here, my nigga.
All right, B, real quick.
I'm going to say yes, sir. I ain't lying to you.
We two men.
Teach me. I say yes, man, because it just cuts, it breaks that burden down.
Right.
Like, I really don't, I'd be like.
And step off.
Slim, it feel good, but it took me a while to get
into
it too, though. So, I mean,
it's
hard.
If it's your spouse, she got to.
No, in our case,
it's
your girl.
Oh, if it's your girl?
Oh,
hell
no.
How long?
No, y'all answer from. No.
How long?
Answer personally.
How long y'all together?
Come on, man, real quick.
If it's your real girl, you can give it a code. If it's your real girl. Like,
email too?
A real girl?
What she need the email for? That's ridiculous. She might.
All right, so look.
That's too much.
I'm a firm believer in privacy is privacy. Now, I have got caught slipping with mine open and some things were being seen. But privacy is privacy. I'm a big person on privacy. Like, yeah, I may have done my dirt, but
can we break 30 more seconds into this real quick? I love healthy relationships, Tom. So I'm going to be honest, man. I think it helps the relationship.
No, when you said it, I was like, damn, maybe she was right. But
you all,
I didn't want to hear that. But
you, you all stressed out in the shower trying to do it all good.
No, because I'm talking Robert. This doesn't matter. Like, ladies ain't going to send it feel good to say, you know what? Charlotte, man, get the number out there for me. People be looking at us sometimes. She grab my phone, I grab her phone. And it'd be...
Nigga, dang.
Like, what's going on? All
right. Jim.
I'm going to agree with BJ because I feel like I believe in the sanctity of marriage.
Where are you coming from? What perspective?
Marriage.
Okay, there you go.
So different. I believe in marriage. I don't have nothing to hide. So I'm going to yell out, answer that for me. Get that for me. So
it's a trust thing. It goes back
coming
to
from where?
So I come from marriage.
Okay,
so.
It is.
You drop that way. You drop that.
Yeah. If I marry somebody,
but all the Murray brothers were saying, if you look back on it.
But I'm gonna tell you how.
Nah, that was smoky.
I'm gonna tell you how we do it though. We both got the same passcodes and everything.
That's smart. Though.
Damn, Tony. Come on, man. I gotta get up here.
Look, but I'm 4 years. Listen, I'm 4 years. I'm about to be 4 years in next month. And when you find that person that you really want, you trust, and you don't want no secrets, no nothing, that's what you do.
You got to go commercial break right now real quick.
And the longer you got the passcode, the less each other half won't even use the passcode.
Nah,
for real, now you said it now, Joe.
How many years you in, though?
Hey, we're going to finish this discussion off air, because I got to take a break on this one.
Unrestricted Radio. We be right back, y'all. We be right back. We be right back. We be right black. All right.
You did.
Oh,
Hey, we back. Hey, it's the Barbershop Lounge, Unrestricted Radio. Wednesdays are Unrestricted.
Hold on.
No, hit that button to get right there at the top. No, all the way at the top. Yeah, hit that. Now we back. We was off for a second. We back in the jump off.
Oh, okay. Okay. All right. I thought we didn't pay our rent again.
Nah. You know, I gave him the joint last week. He counted twice, like Smokey on Friday. He was like, one, two. He turned that joint over. I was like,
hey, look, I know we had Unrestricted Guy Talk, but I let a homie of mine come and crash and tell y'all about what she got going on. You know, it's always that one woman come in the barbershop when the guy's talking.
Uh-huh.
And I can hang with the fellas, too. See, the fellas like when I talk, too, because I'm not one of those biased women. I actually feel like I kind of understand it more than the female race does.
So you're all about the side chick movement, right?
Mm. Okay. So tell us why you're here.
She's like, I ain't that cool, man.
So, you know, here's the thing. I just think that women overthink things sometimes, and I have been a woman before. But I didn't come here to invade you guys, you know, barbershop talk.
Because strippers going to be here soon once you get out.
No, I like female strippers. Women are beautiful, you know, and I just don't, men are not attractive. It's not. It's, I mean, you know, just don't.
So you telling me all the times that I did the R. Kelly, there'll be.
You can do it for your wife.
I know, but you, I mean, okay.
See, you doing it for your wife is a totally different thing than you making it a profession, because that shit ain't cute for me.
So tell us what you here for, girl. You done bum rush everything.
I know.
Yes,
but
yes.
We love you, though.
Well, thank you so much, because I love you, too. You funny as shit, so I love you, Dwayne.
Aha.
So. Don't you and I'm not one of his vibes. Aha.
Yes,
I'm about to get your vibe.
I always got to clear that up.
Well, I had an ex. Woo, boy.
You had to.
She could way. Not stand 10, and not no 10 worth nothing.
Yes. And so I'm here because Eli Media is putting on a fall concert series, and I will be here October 1st, and I'm very, very excited about that. It's going to be starting about 10:30 p.m., and cover charge is $10, which, you know.
And you're going to be doing your thing with the band, right?
Oh, yeah, live.
So you bring a date, Smoke. It's only $20.
So that's 40 for two or for... We'll talk about that later. So keep on.
So,
they take EBT card. At I got 80 on it.
Yeah.
Wait, Ted.
So you know, I'm going to be performing my music live and just singing some familiar tunes by my favorite artists like Bernie Lodge, Jill Scott, Erykah Badu. But I'm just going to be introducing people to the sounds of Tia Day.
Okay.
So I'm very, very excited about that. You know, if you want to check me out and see what my credibility is all about, you can definitely visit my YouTube channel, and that is /TIADAE, and that is my website as well. So
I can sing too, T.
All right,
both time on.
So
I just don't sound good.
So that's Tia Day, the fall concert series, October 1st, 10 p.m. right here at the Everlasting Life. That's 9185. Central Avenue, right. And come on down, and you're going to get some good music because this girl can sing.
I definitely want to see that because I love music.
Now, we got to give my man Zoe his time to say his plug.
Oh, hell yeah.
Now, y'all know what it is. For anybody who has never been to my birthday party, sorry to hear that. And for those who have been there, you know what y'all in store for. All right, October 29th is going down. We got the Hilton and Boston Commons in Virginia. We got a team for me.
That's a nice place, y'all. So.
Subtle Thoughts.
Two good bands.
And top five. Masquerade Ball. It's called Fright Night. So you could bring your Halloween costume, or you could do your masquerade thing. You know what I mean? We're doing cash prizes for the best costume, best masquerade. And this is going to be off the hook. That's my birthday party. Everybody knows when I throw a party, I throw a party. So.
I mean, it sounds like, hold on. So, familiar faces.
Familiar faces.
Subtle Thoughts. Top five. Masquerade, party, costume, and they're giving away money.
And the DJ T.Y., but look, this time we broke it down.
Man, T.Y.
Right?
Shout out T.Y.
Yeah, T.Y. can go too, right? So I'm going to break it out. For the VIP people that purchase the VIP, y'all have y'all own ballroom. We're going to have their own DJ in that ballroom. We're going to have food in there for you. We're going to have our own bar. We're working on liquor sponsors and stuff now, so that's to be continued, you know what I'm saying? But for the VIP, we're actually going to make it like a real VIP where you can actually separate yourself from the party and have your own party.
So it's going to be a real VIP. Because yeah, I've been to a VIP where I just sat into a table over the side. There wasn't even no rope.
Tell him.
I'd have been happy with some rope.
Tell him why you're mad, son.
But you know, I just got set over to the side at a table.
Hey, look, they were like, hold on. They were like, what package you got? Oh, you don't deserve these places. Right. Took the plate from the I was like, damn.
We had no silverware, no cups.
I was like, we ain't get the upgrade package? You was like, nah, cuz.
We're going to roll out the red carpet. We're going to treat people right, man. You know what I mean? And the early bird tickets are all for a hotel party, only $25. Early bird tickets.
Any room rates?
We're actually working on that now. That's actually a good question, because me personally, I don't like to drive in Virginia. I don't care if I'm going on a trip to Florida, whoever I'm riding with, I'm getting the passengers in the driver's seat to Virginia, I'll pick up in North Carolina. So, you know, I'm not going to understand people don't want
to. That boy's smart. That's why he said he ain't going to jail.
Right. So, with that being said, we're trying to work out everything now. We've been having a little bit of discrepancies, but it's actually working out. We're working everything out. So, as soon as I get the home information, I'm definitely going
to
drop it for us.
So, where can they follow you to get their information real quick?
You can go to my page on David Zoe Wilkerson. That's my Facebook. We actually got Fright Night Masquerade Affair. At Eventbrite, you can purchase tickets there on Eventbrite. You can go down to Shears on MLK. You can get tickets from there. You can call anybody to sing for me. You can get tickets from them. Like I said, you holler my brother Mo Kemp. That's what I'm doing this event with. Shout out to Mo Kemp.
Shout out Mo Kemp.
Yeah, Brother Love Entertainment, you know what I mean? So, like, we in the streets, and we got a lot of people supporting, a lot of people showing love, a lot of people selling tickets, and we make it happen.
I personally can't allow you to give all these shout outs and not give shout out to that person that did your graphics. I mean, you know.
First of all,
that's our home team right here, you know. That's our home team.
I've been supporting this young lady for years. I'm told. But when she was like, all right, that's what I'm gonna do, I was like, show me. You know what I mean? But I have the best graphic designer in the DMV, hands down. I put my money on her work against anybody, and I said that on Facebook Live and on radio. Angie is the best, hands down.
AW Graphics.
And I put my money, any amount of money you want to bet it, I guarantee the people that she didn't work for, they'll put up with me to make sure we cover whatever you want to throw up.
And that's for sure right there. And I can stand that, because she put me on the fly and I had like 5 pimples on my face. She made them just disappear and gave me that smooth Denzel blend. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know it's 100%.
Nah, she actually, her graphic design speaks volumes. I'm talking about, like, I have had people to say, okay, I've been to this kind of pink and white party. I've been there. But they see that fly, I'm like, ooh, that's a nice fly. I got to check this out.
Yeah. One of your flies was done so good. See, people got to realize that. You got to look at her details. Yeah. It's the actual hotel in the background from an early view. The girl just standing there. You got to look at stuff like that.
Yeah, but if I threw some of my old flies from like my 80s and 90s party I had, which we sold out and brought out 1,600 people, and I'm talking about the money, I'm not talking about, you know, the click at the door. Yeah. I count the cash.
Cash, you know what I mean?
So, if we had parties way more than that. Like, from the pink and white parties we done had, from, like, I can name the all black parties we had. Like, I can name so many flyers that I've had, and I can put them up against all of these flyers that these other guys are making. They be looking like cabaret flyers.
Yes, sir.
I call them the Black Planet flies. Yeah. It looked like a Black Planet background, and it'd be like one dude standing there, like.
But we're going to have to get a commercial fee for Angie, because we didn't plug her like I was wet. She deserves it though.
Yeah, but good. She is our graphic designer as well, and she chose Lizzo.
Love you, Angie.
So actually, we plugged that, but unfortunately, we got to kick Tia off right now.
That's fine.
Because this is Back to Guys Talk, and we got some juicy.
Hey, go make us some sandwiches.
She gonna fire you up.
Please.
Maybe that was please. Him. That wasn't me. So. Right, come on back, BJ.
Come on, BJ. Let's get finished.
All right, let's get these juicy joints. Pause. Let's go.
Hey, I ain't in the same room with him. I ain't in the same room. All right, so we got a little bit of time, and I'm gonna. We gotta keep it quick. We gotta keep it quick. Number one, why do men lie for no reason?
Because we love them.
Because we all do.
Because the truth hurts sometimes.
Well, we protect them because we love
them. Keep them hurting them.
Because it's a habit.
It went off. Like I said, keep from hurting.
I agree. Because we love them and we don't want to hurt them.
And, but I don't lie, so here we go.
That's real talk.
No, no, it always protect your feelings. Protect your feelings.
Right, exactly. Number one. Why don't men ever fight for their baby mamas in courts for rights as parents?
Oh, wow. Honestly, I don't think good fathers deserve to go to court. So a lot of times, like, it's out of frustration because they don't want to deal with the court system. But I don't think it's the kids.
Most of us just like so not to see the court, put nobody in between us.
Of course, you can tell you how to be a father.
Of course, you determine family. I do see more men fighting for their kids now, though.
It's easier now.
Now they actually will give a man.
Father lives matter.
Yes. Father lives matter.
So I think dudes just been in court for other stuff too much. So you know the have that part on you is like
it's like a stigma.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Uneducated on the process.
That might be number one.
Damn, oh, Michael Maxwell.
That's what I said. Bring Gino. This is fine. That guy, BJ, you know me and him only got a GED put together.
You are absolutely right. Yeah, we're not educated on the process. And not to mention, we feel like, okay, if I'm taking off from work, that's money I could be paying for my child. But you got me down here for the school system.
All right.
So, why do men lose interest in their longtime girlfriends and wives?
Let me answer that. I'm not asking because I'm going through it. I'm actually happy.
That's right. Put that out there.
But now, I'm saying that because I think people get complacent and they don't do the things they used to do to keep their mate. So a lot of times they get bored and things change.
BJ?
I think we forget, Jeff.
I think things become too routine. When you first meet somebody, y'all sleeping together or during the day on Saturdays, in the morning time and everything. Once it progresses, it's only at nighttime. Then it goes from only every other night, and then it's only on the weekends, and then you're looking for a side chick.
So I think dudes forget that.
No, people. That's just because girls do it too.
Yeah. The chase period. Okay.
I think you forget about the qualities that attract you to that person, and you forget how, like, when other people see the person you with, how bad they is to them, and you so used to seeing them all the time, and you know, you just forget about it. But people don't dress up and go out no more. They, you know, let's just watch a movie here.
Exactly.
You know, get your ass up and let's get dressed and let's, you know.
I'm not ashamed of that. I don't want to get too much details, but I agree. Complacent. And you forget how to love that person like you fell in love with them.
If you need it, post a picture of your girl on Facebook and then go look at all the dudes that like it. And then that's when you'll feel something. You're like, I need to go get my woman's flowers.
Yeah, yeah. Right. That's true. That's true. Like, you see your girl every day, you're like, but you know, you take her out.
She posts that picture, you're like, 200 likes? God damn! Like,
good therapy, though.
All right, so real quick. Is one woman ever going to be enough?
Yes. One woman could be enough if she becomes every woman. Because men want variety. We want a whore. We want a slut. We want a lover. We want all of that. So if she becomes every woman, a man will always be fulfilled if she becomes every woman. Yeah.
Well. Everything going to answer Zoe. Yeah. But that's really it, though. Like, she can, but I think I'm going to be straight up. We gotta be all right with ourselves, too, though.
Right. I agree.
As long as the man, like I said, as long as the man's all right with himself, and there are women out there that is every woman, like he said.
Yeah,
because
you got women. I don't do that.
Tony, I remember Zoe, and then I add on if she likes sports and she got God in her life.
Right. That's awesome. That's heavy.
I agree with Zoe.
You agree with Zoe?
Hey, he hit it nail on the head, man. I told you I believe in the sanctity of marriage, so one woman is enough.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not gonna lie. I've done some horse things in my days, and if I get married, I can't speak. You know.
Okay.
If I get married, I am going to try my best. My best. My best.
To make sure that one of that your every woman, she like, she her. She
like,
could.
I, she definitely has to be everything I want. Like,
and a, like a real free.
If I want to say, like, look, I need some new stuff tonight, she better go, I don't know, shave it different. I don't know, do something to it.
Give it the Hitler mustache, yeah, boo.
It's different. It's different when you... Look, it's different when you just have a girl, right?
Right. Right. That's
because, like when I was out there, I had a girl that I just wanted to party with. I had a girl I wanted sex with, chill with. I could take you to the movies and like, yeah, you
right.
You it's never that. Enough when you're single.
You're right.
Yeah.
But us as men need to voice that too, because it's weak men out here that won't voice what they want and what they need to their woman, so they'll go out and find that other woman to fulfill.
But then
it's
other
that take offense when you do.
But right. Exactly. Because then you got too many women that's too damn strong. They don't. I don't care what you want. It's about me. I mean, then you know that. Oh, that's a different topic. All right, come on.
All right, next question. Next question.
So why do men feel like they can fuck up over and over?
And over. And over. Keep going. Keep going.
And over.
You know what?
Their women, they can't never have a break. They feel like their woman can't never have a breaking point.
Because we are stupid. Men are stupid. I'm sorry. We are so fucking stupid. Like, we're dumb.
Okay. BJ.
Hey, he right.
Because we are stupid. We are stupid and dumb and stupid. And we think they stupid sometimes.
We Lamar Sanders. We big dummies. We just...
Stupid. Dumb.
There you go.
I agree. We stupid when we think we smart. We say stupid.
And considerate at the end of that.
From my point of view, I feel like we feel like they are used to the dumb shit that we do. So we expect for them to accept our dumbness.
Yes.
Our mistakes. All right,
next question.
Why is a side chick okay, but a side dude is always a no?
Because a woman, I'm about to get real deep on
this. Uh-oh, hold up. We got to come back to this one. Come on, BJ.
I'm about to go all the way deep on this one.
He grounded himself with this joint.
Come on, fellas. We got
really
a little
no
time left.
There's no such thing as a side dude for real.
What?
That is true.
It's really no such thing as a side dude.
That is true.
I kind of agree with him because, like Zoe said earlier, most of the time women attach sex with emotions.
Right.
So if they're having sex with a man, there are some women. Yes, there are some women that have sex with a man without emotion, but not many.
Girls have boyfriends. For real.
A lot of them.
The Murray girls that I know that cheat, and I'm on camera saying it. They have husbands and boyfriends.
They're not just mad.
Hey, hold on. We got to get to Tony. Tony.
I forgot what we talking about.
Why is a side chick okay, but a side dude is no?
I think a side dude is definitely just a dude just a smasher. He not no feelings involved at all.
Yeah,
okay.
I don't
want to
get hit.
John
hit or anything.
I don't believe in either.
That's respectable.
I don't believe in either.
I probably think Gino plays.
No, I know. I believe Gino serious. I believe he's serious.
I got to get my answer. All
right, real quick, Zoe. Come on. We got 9 minutes.
It's not okay to have a side chick, but biblically, from the beginning of time, men, it was okay for men to have multiple wives as long as they can afford them.
Right.
So I think that's why it's acceptable, because it's been acceptable since the beginning of time for a man to have multiple women. But it's never okay to have a side chick or a side nigga, and I'm saying it right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so next question is, why is it okay to make a baby but marriage isn't an option first?
But
woo!
The ladies know how to pull out. I don't think it's okay. Stupid.
It's not okay, and it should be accepted, and it is accepted. And
Lamar Sanford.
Yo.
I'm telling you, stupid.
Pull out names, terrible.
Horrible.
You went in wrong, literally.
You answer that one too, D. You about to skip over that joke, cuz.
Hey, so.
I mean, honestly, if you have your first one, I mean, it's kind of like, you know.
It's like making a Hot Pocket. Once you get the right microwave time, you know exactly.
You know, kind of like,
it's never going to be frozen in the middle again.
You know, you know, you put it in the center.
He's like, you just poke a little hole in the top of the joint, and then it's like. Next question.
Why are men so afraid to commit? Real quick. You got to.
I think men aren't as desirable as women, so we feel like we still got something that might be coming to us that we might be missing, so we just like ain't trying to lock down as quick. Women, every time they go out of their door, they got 100 dudes after them. Us, we go out, we be looking out like, who the hell's out here? Where's Bay at? And then, you know, so we always feel like it's something else out there.
I think it's deeper than that. I think it's more of a situation where sometimes men don't tap into their feelings. They don't want to love. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
So I agree with that, too.
So I don't think it's a situation where we just like, oh, we just not want to be scared of commitment. I think we're scared to tap into a certain part of letting people into our heart.
Absolutely.
Because when we love all. And we are, that's how men go crazy.
BJ?
I think that's after what I'm going to say. I think we grow later and longer. Mm-hmm. Like by the time we grow into a man, a real man, not age or amount of joints out here. Yeah. By the time I grow into a man, now I'm searching for love. So it took us 5 years to be together for me to actually accept where I am as a man. And I love you unconditionally.
Right, right. Tony,
TCB.
So I agree with BJ because it takes a man longer to get to
level maturity.
Yeah, that takes forever.
You know,
I think it's because the way we were taught as kids, you know, it has been put to, in society that we're not supposed to get in touch with our feelings. We're not supposed to feel. We're not supposed to love. We're supposed to be hard.
It's ingrained
and all this stuff. And that goes into what BJ was saying is the level of maturity. When we get to a certain age, we realize that, you know, I need to be loved. I need
to show some emotion.
I want to be held. Right.
So I got another one.
Let's go.
So next question. Do you think social media is responsible? No, do you think social media and relationships should be separated?
Hell yeah.
Yes.
My man. Oh, BJ, don't blow it for me, BJ. Don't do it, BJ.
We're not friends?
Like you.
Maybe I'm listening to what you're saying.
Do you think social media and your relationship should be separate?
Tell me how. Give me an example.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you for me.
Give me some
how. Wife and relationship-wise.
Okay.
From both promoters. Okay. So we're going to know majority women.
Okay, yeah, okay.
So, oh, hey, sweetie, hey, love, how you doing? I'm just telling my partner, blah, blah, blah.
Okay. Check your girl face. Check your Facebook.
May think that, you know, that's crossing the line. You saying sweetie, baby, or something like that. But I'm always told, whoever I'm with, look, women going to support me. Dudes ain't really going to support me.
Who's going to support the women?
Exactly. So if I'm nice to the women, they're going to be tough. They're going to bring their people out because Dwayne's a sweet guy. Blah, 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 blah.
Right, right.
Do you think it should be separate from business and person?
Damn.
But see, you kind of like, yours is kind of, yours is borderline too, though.
If you have an understanding woman and she knows that, that basically, like, I know social media is fake and people put up facades of who they want to be or the persona they want people to think they are.
Right.
Then if you ever understand the woman, then you can keep it the same. We have a jealous woman. At that point in time, I'm not telling you who like this, who like that. Like, then it should be separate.
Hey, I don't want to take up too much time, but I'm going to be up. Now, but you know your wife. I'm not saying she like this, but you know there's some people out there, female-wise, going to press their luck.
Right.
I just know Zoe for her. So they're going to be trying to do this and that.
Right.
They're going to be a little extra.
Extra on the comment.
You can keep them at bay, but they're going to be a little extra.
It's all the maturity of your wife.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
My man.
And it's how you respond to it, too.
Yeah.
It's how you respond to it.
I think it's different wife and girlfriend.
Are you saying me personally?
No. I feel like it goes with the maturity of your lady, but it's also how you respond to it. Because like you said, when she was walking around and knew all these dudes, as long as she was respectful towards me, I'm good with it. As long as you show that respect towards her when you answering these chicks and you know they get a little, you know, crossing that line, if you don't respond to it, you good. That's how I
would do it. But it can ruin your relationship.
What if you like the comment? If you like the comment,
they're not going to respond at all.
See, I'm guilty of that. If somebody comment on my, I just press like. I just press like.
To acknowledge that, okay, I'm showing you respect.
Exactly.
It doesn't mean like,
exactly.
That means something.
that's not the case.
If I put a picture on it, like, oh, you looking good. Like, I'm like, oh, thanks, man. I'm not like,
this all goes back to the hustle. You know, when they know your grind off the break, because entertainment, whatever you're doing in entertainment, going to draw females regardless.
If you're a male, that's going to be your fans.
Hold on, I can't hear that. What you say again?
I said, if you're in the entertainment industry, period, whatever you're doing, it's going to draw females. So if your wife, your girl, understand that entertainment draw females, and you're not going to jump out there with them, then you know, that's what it is.
Did I get everybody?
I think it's a difference. Girlfriend, no. Wife, yes.
Girlfriend, no. Unrestricted Radio Show will be looking for a new co-host.
No. You don't. If it's your girlfriend, y'all keep it separate. But when you finally get married, then you can say, okay, we're an official unit. We're not going to backtrack out of this. After this 6 months, you're not going to see me with a new girlfriend and I have to erase all the pictures that I put up from before.
Okay, I got you from that.
That was personal.
That announcement has been closed now.
D, what you saying?
All right, so look. When in a relationship and you all don't live together, how often do you see them or do you think you should see them? Daily, weekly, or monthly?
How far they live? Because if they live in Waldorf mode.
Hey, you in a relationship.
Like you live in a Waldorf mode?
I mean, daily, weekly, or
monthly.
3 to 4 times a week.
I got like I see you every day.
Right.
But don't be talking shit when I got rolling on because I got to do something later.
I'm with you on that one.
If you say every day, do you have a small draw?
Hold on, we're gonna go on that. Hold on. So he's saying every day. Come on, Smoke, real quick.
Weekends.
Okay. Cody.
Every other day. I don't want to make it like that we get on each other's nerves. So every other day for me.
Gina.
Yeah.
Nah, if I'm really feeling you, it's every day. Like I need to see you. Every day.
Who said every other day?
I'm
with someone.
I need
my little space. I ain't gonna lie.
Weekends and once during the week.
I'm with that. 3 days, every other day.
I'll be the street, so I can see her every day. I ain't gonna be in the house all day.
Well, that's true. Hold on. But the answer is though. Hold on. The answer is though. Do you get a draw? Do they get a draw? Yes or no?
Do they get a small draw at your house, and do you get a small draw
at your house? Hold on, now ask her real quick. Do they get a draw at your house? Yes or no?
If we're exclusive, yes, she can have 3 draws.
Boyfriend, girlfriend,
no.
No. Overnight bag.
No, but y'all exclusive.
Oh, no, every exclusive. Overnight bag.
You're in a relationship. This your book. This your girl.
No, that's your girl. You're not hitting up with yours. That's your girl.
Okay, she get a joint.
She can keep a toothbrush.
Hold on.
I give up the sock, bro.
Okay.
I'll give her a drawer.
Okay, I give her a drawer, too.
I give it a little, the Tupperware joint with the wheels on it that you can see through, that you can move in and out the room.
Family Dollar.
I give it a drawer.
I'm
giving her the draws.
Got the draws, dog.
I'm playing, but we get a draw. All right, so we about to get our little mouth transplant, Mr. Sensitivity. All
right.
Why is showing emotion such a negative thing?
Because we've been taught that was a sign of weakness.
Yep. Ever since we was kids, when your mother used to slap the shit out of you and then tell you, I dare you to cry. Yeah. We've been taught to hold our emotions.
Or your uncle punch you in your chest and say, you better not cry.
You better man up.
Yeah, we've been taught that way.
And we feel vulnerable if we do let that go.
But it killed us, though.
Because you're going to use that every time.
That's why most of us crazy.
Yeah.
We hold that in.
But you know what? I respect women to the utmost because, like, for some reason, a woman is so much, they built for so much more pain than a man.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
A woman can accept a man for things that they've done to them over years. And the first time you do it, so man, you're going to kick.
Because you
can't have a pride that pride is a mother.
Good question. How do you feel about a female that curse?
It depends if it's at me.
I'm with you on that, brother.
Can't cuss all day, man.
I don't like when
they
smoke.
I don't.
I hate it.
Hold up. Wait.
She can cuss as much as she wants, because I cuss a lot. So we just work on it each other.
I honestly think it's a turn off. because you know, I feel like it don't look good on us. Especially if you're a bad chick.
And you have a good vocabulary.
It don't look good. Yeah, it don't look good. I agree.
Right.
I don't like it because I feel like I'm talking to myself. What's up, my nigga? What's up, nigga?
Right. I'm with you. I don't like the woman to curse. I don't like the woman to curse too. But we all gonna put a spin since they just did it. Yeah. Smoker or no smoker?
Weed only. Weed only.
Okay. She smoking weed?
Weed only.
And she smoked curry.
She chain smoke. That's better.
I'm talking about no cigarettes, but if it was a
cigar,
weed.
I'm talking about weed.
Yeah. Gino,
I used to, but not now. And I smoke cigarettes, but she can't smoke with me.
But you know what? She can smoke a cigarette.
Me personally, I don't like smoke cigarettes, so I'm gonna say no.
I know you don't like this. Is get my car. Oh, you smoking it again, cuz? Like,
so okay. All right. So yeah. All right. Next question. After having a one night stand, would you be interested in actually dating a female again?
Yes.
You had to think about that.
Depending on the sex.
Yeah.
Okay. Now let's add that suspense. Would you date her again?
Nah.
Would you date her again?
If it was bomb.com.
Would you date her again?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
I would date her again.
Because you know that sex.
If the sex was whack.
I ain't coming back.
It depends. I'm on Facebook Live. I can't comment.
Gotcha. I respect that. Okay. Okay.
If the sex was whack, I might try it out one more time to see if, depending on what I was.
With you?
If the sex was whack, I ain't coming back.
Oh, can I put a smile on that?
Hold on. We're going to come around.
Nah.
I believe in second chances.
I believe in that. I believe in sex. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. I believe in them too.
I'm going to put a spin on that. The sex was whack, but she was fat to death.
Oh. I've been there, done that.
He put it in his face.
I've been there, done that.
How did that do?
You know what? I think when she's fat to death and the sex is wet, it makes me say no. I probably, because it's like, damn, my hopes was up so high.
But those the ones that.
But if she was actually like average and the sex was wet, I'm like, so maybe she might have been nervous, you know?
But I'm going to be honest. I mean, all right, so real guy, hold on.
I come back.
Have you ever had somebody with a badass body, but they couldn't fuck?
Yes. 100%.
But see, that's because they're not used to it. Other people that don't have.
You got to train.
Exactly. But even.
It's like it's probably like buying a used car. Like you want it when you buy a used car, you want it to be like fresh on the inside, ridden but not too hard. You know what I'm saying? Like like one owner, like one or two owners. That's it. You know, like you don't want it. Like
you know how if everybody thinks this chick is bad, right? And your homeboy hit it, and he tell y'all, you know,
not go ahead.
He tell y'all that it was whack. Don't that break your heart? Like. Everybody's looking at this chick and one of your homeboys hit her like, yo, how was it?
I hope my mother ain't listening, man. Yeah. I done did a lot of wild joints. Wayne, though.
Yeah. Allegedly.
A lot of wild joints.
Don't have your wife ask me nothing about me. Don't do it.
But I'm just saying, man, if I'm one night in the joint, I don't think I done did a lot of weird joints.
What if it's a surprise one night? You wasn't planning on like.
I normally plan about one night before I go to the club.
Yeah. When I was single, come on, put the thing back on. When I was single.
All right. So let's dumb it down because we got 7 minutes. All right. So, how important is it that your family like your significant other?
Me personally, honestly, I don't care because if I love you, you my ride or die. Your parents, my parents. My cousins, if they don't like her, that's so goddamn what. Mm-hmm. If you don't spend the rest of life with each other, it's me and you against the world.
Mm-hmm. It means a lot, but it don't matter.
That's
perfect answer.
Yeah.
Alley-oop it.
Tony.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Gino.
I don't give a good goddamn.
I don't care if you like me or not. and I don't care if my family like her or not. It's because Bible says a woman leaves her father and becomes one with the man. So we in this together. We are one. If you don't like her, you don't like me.
Unfortunately, I'm always the one not being liked by the family. So it's like, you know.
You know where that question
like,
came from.
Fuck this question. All right, so come on. Let me give you one. Okay, so this last one here. Okay, so Why in the world is it so hard for a man to commit to a good woman instead of trying to be a player? I do all I can for my baby daddy, but can't get him to commit. Why? He obviously knows I'm not crazy. I'm independent financially. I cook, clean, take care of his daughter at times, and give it to him how he wants it and likes it. What else could a man want? Okay, I'm not finished yet.
Part one.
I know he messes with other females and is on plenty, on multiple dating sites like Tag and Plenty of Fish. I don't understand what's more, what more a man could want. I know he's upset because I'm pregnant. Yes, by him. And he didn't want any more kids. Has two. And the fact that I even got pregnant to begin with was just a fluke. But that should have a basis of whether or not he wants to be with me. He told me the other day that we would already be together if I had not got pregnant.
Ooh.
He already knows I'll be a great mom because he see how I am with his son and daughter. Okay. I don't know. Maybe y'all can enlighten me.
Real quick. I'm make it real quick. niggas love hoes. She give everything to him and without a commitment. Why buy the cow? You get the milk for free.
Okay. Tom, any input?
I gotta let this sit for a minute.
All right, that's it. That's Smoke.
She can't. A baby's not gonna keep a man. A man gotta be kept himself. He gotta want to be kept. So if he ain't keeping you before you had a baby, the baby's not gonna keep him.
No, he was good. They were good.
Oh, the baby is what actually kind of set up. If
he don't want no more kids,
he don't. Then why does she have a kid?
Uh-oh, you about to? Oh. Hey, we still need all our women viewers.
No. What I mean is like, why did she actively seek that? Or I'm not sure because she didn't say.
She said she got pregnant on a fluke.
Oh, okay, on a fluke. So
a fluke. What's a fluke? Because if you didn't pull out, that ain't fluke.
Right.
But she can't control him though. You know what I'm saying?
But
she can control him.
Control herself too.
That is true. But she can't control him.
She
that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, but that's what I think about. Because she ain't hot show because they've been together for a long time. So he know that she want to work.
I personally feel like it's resentment because she got pregnant.
Yeah. I think the problem is she talks too much.
I said
long ass letter she got.
Hey, I had to get my Steve Harvey thing.
Yeah, no, he's like, let me. That's all right. Don't worry, Steve Harvey. We coming for y'all.
Right. I personally think the nigga's just a coward. I think he's been running from it the whole time relationship. I think he's been running from the commitment. I think he's running from responsibility to being a father. So
that does sound.
He's got issues of just being a man. He probably had a father.
But I was just about to say, bro, I used to have commitment problems, and I think it's because it was me and my father's situation.
Right.
And shout out to my father. I think he listened. You know, I love him. What's up, Bob?
Shout out to your father.
Yeah, he is.
Right, if you don't have that good connection, I mean, I don't mean to be rude, but if you don't really have a connection with your dad, you really don't know how to be that fatherly figure. Yeah. Now, you may know how to be a big brother or that cool-ass cousin type of atmosphere, but, you know, you being a father is kind of...
Bro, deep talk, 10 seconds, I really believe that's why I used to have commitment issues, for real. Because I used to be like, man, I'm going to see my mom this weekend. Yeah, I'm going to buy that dress. It's Saturday, he ain't there.
That's my father Cadillac.
That's funny. That's funny because my commitment issues came from my mother's side. Like all the women in my life, like it was just drama, drama, drama. And I'm like, I'm a fun person. So when I'm dealing with drama, yeah, that's not me.
All right, real quick, Dad, I got one question. I promise we get out of here. Just one. I'm just gonna throw this out there because this person threw this out. It's kind of I had to get this one out there. Come on.
Well, my commitment issues came from military. Seeing how husband and wives were in the military, as soon as they husband deployed, the wives in the club trying to
get oh, yeah. Ooh, do that.
Man, couldn't get me to get with that.
Mine came from my father not being there. So my whole life, I've always had to try to find a way to be a man. Like, I don't know how to be a husband. Yeah. I don't know how to be a father. Like, I'm learning on the wing. I'm winging it. You know, I'm really winging it. And I never had that figure in my life. So a lot of my mistakes that I'm making, I know that I wouldn't have made the mistakes if I had proper guidance.
And you got to surround yourself around upper burden.
Like-minded men.
Well, my issue is I was raised by my mother and my aunt. So I didn't really get to be around other guys, like men, older men, until I got in my teenagers. Yes. Mm-hmm. Even now when I'm with my sons, I don't know if I should be like, what? You know, or I should be like, come here, let me hug you. You know, stuff like that. It's kind of like iffy because I didn't have it. You know what I'm saying? So, as we said earlier, I try to, we were taught to, you know, be tough. So, I'm kind of teaching them that tough love. But deep down in me, I know that's the wrong shit to be doing because, you know, I mean, right. You know what I'm saying? So,
you got to teach them that men can cry too.
Right, exactly. So, you know, with my youngest boy, you know, he jive up with his mother, but I try to bring him up, look. You don't need to be up with your mother all the time. You know, I mean, dad, come over here. Chill, talk to me, blah, blah, blah. All right, so this one is going to be a freak nasty joint before we get out of here.
Okay. And I know a little freak.
Turn that camera.
In Hollywood.
Hey, turn that camera.
I think we need to go and step outside.
Nah, cuz, you standing here, Mo. All
right, this is a weird joint right here. If a guy gets a rim job and it turns him on, in parentheses.
Hold on, what's a rim job?
Getting your butthole lit. Oh! Don't ask me how I knew that fast, but I'm just saying.
In parentheses, penis gets super hard while having it done.
Oh.
Does that insinuate he likes anal play and may have bisexual tendencies?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
She hit that tank.
You don't think so?
No.
Hey, so.
I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you.
The radio show is looking for a new co-host.
I'm going to tell you right now. I have had a chick go down and she, you know, she went down, you know what I'm saying? I was like, whoa, you know what I'm saying? My dick was already hard now. You know what I'm saying? I didn't lay down with my dick soft and then and like all of a sudden the dick got hard. Nah, she went down, you know what I'm saying? Went a little past the balls. I was like, oh shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, whoa. I was like, don't penetrate it, but just go around, like, just like around, like. So now I know. Stick out your tongue. Let me see how long it is. Because if it's too long, I ain't fucking with you. Cause I was like, don't go around. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's what happened. You know, it's real life.
Gino,
wait for a man to get his ass licked.
I'm with you, Gino. I'm with you.
Kick your legs up.
No, you don't really got to kick your legs up. You don't really got to kick your legs up like that. Nah, I'm trying to tell you.
Smoke had his legs on the wall.
Nah. I'm not even that flexible. I'm not. I'm not.
On the wall. Oh my God, Tony.
I can't even get down.
First of all, I'd be mad because I don't shave my asshole. So the fact that she's licking it, I have a problem with that.
Look, if she want to play around in the ass fro, that's on her, okay? I can't, you know.
And if she want a fur burger, it's on her.
Look, I'm not going to shave my ass, so that's what it is. Like, if she, and it's happened before, I don't ask for it, but it did happen one time. And I enjoyed
it. Hey, it happened to me before. It happened before. But the question really is, if you really like that, then you really need it.
I know.
If your man really like that, then he's asking.
He
got a problem.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I agree.
No, hold on.
After this,
would you do it? Would you do it to turn your woman on? If you knew that turned your woman on?
Fuck no.
No. Would you do it?
Okay. I know some dudes that really is just freaked all out and just don't give a good goddamn. They're just a sexual.
Yeah, they'd be like, shit, yeah, I eat an ass, you can eat my ass.
My man, he go hard. Listen, yeah. No homo. And he can tell you the minute.
You got to call me legs, really, put it up.
Hey.
I knew the voice. You know the voice.
On a serious note, because
you don't got
cocky
legs, though.
On a serious note, at the end of the day, I appreciate all of you fellas coming out here. I have one more thing. With all these senseless murders to our black men, what would you say to one of the boys if you had a chance? Something positive.
To the ones that were murdered?
Not to the Chicago gangsters, to Southeast gangsters.
Any kid, just coming from a positive perspective.
Value your life. And live every day like it's your last.
STOT, stop. Seek time to pay.
Yeah, it's been last week, didn't it? Monday. What was it, Monday?
Last Thursday?
Something like that.
I tried.
It was in my notes last week, but I ain't even. Go ahead.
Think about your future. You have a future. The stuff you're doing now can't affect your future. So don't do nothing stupid to cut off your future. Don't end your life now for no reason.
I would basically say look at your kids' life and look at your everybody in your family, your mother, your father. Do you want them alive to you?
Well, I would tell them that this is a plan that they have for you. This is a box they put you in. Let the top off. Get out of here. This world bigger than your neighborhood.
Put God first.
Box.
I personally want to say find something that you love and cherish it. Because once you really have something that you love, you start to look like different. Like, especially
awesome.
With my kids.
But you know, I'm going to take it a step further. Love and cherish yourself.
That.
You want to? Love and cherish yourself.
Shit right here.
If you love and cherish yourself and you treat every woman like she's your sister or your mother with the utmost respect, I think your life will be a lot longer.
Man. I ain't gonna lie. Until I had my daughter, that's when I was like,
what?
Yeah. I'm sorry, man. I like man. Exactly. Real quick, tell the people who you are.
I got three joints.
DJ Boy, he's the bow tie.
I'm Smokey. You already know who I am.
It's your boy TZB talking, man.
Gino with Boys the Bow Ties.
Wayne, Unrestricted Radio Show. This is the first session of Unrestricted
Barbershop Lounge. Hey, it was
Unrestricted
successful.
God Talk.
Man, make sure you invite us back.
Hey, Slim, hey, we gonna do this.
We gonna.
Same group. Hey, same group. Same group. Okay, we gotta get out of here because we got her working overtime. But I appreciate you fellas coming out here.
This is what we do each and every week. Wednesdays are Unrestricted. This is the Unrestricted Radio Show, and we will see y'all next
October
week.
October 29th!
Oh, October 29th!
October 29th! Be there!
Be there!
Is it Freak Night?
What?
Is it Freak Night?
If you want it to be.
All right, hey, now!
Get your room. Go down to the Hilton.
Hey, shout out E-Life Media, y'all.
Hey, E-Life Media. Boys the Bow Ties. We out. My man.